Code is a project which I first came up with the idea for about over 10 years ago. I was in university at the time. I was studying at the University of Stirling. And the original version of it came about because I had a really bad breakup and I was feeling very bitter about the world. It kind of sat in a drawer for a long time. I went off to Japan, came back. I think I became a bit more mature as a person. Then I was going through kind of like old script ideas because, you know, I've created filmmaking. And I rediscovered the idea. And I thought, you know, like, there's a really kind of interesting, I think, an unexplored overlap between mental health issues and Christmas time. Well, this was actually about, you know, someone who was struggling with severe mental health issues and they couldn't connect, they couldn't talk about it. And that became the idea for it. So the film was retooled in that direction. And I thought, you know, this actually could mean a lot to a lot of people. This actually does have some substance to it. Every year Christmas came and went and I hadn't had time to get around to it. I just had the idea at the back of mind, I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. 2017, I spoke to Rowan. We met up in Ambleside, had a chat about it. I pitched the idea to her. She responded really positively to the idea.
So I first met Gavin because someone that I knew in uni said, I know someone that's doing a short film. Do you want to be in it? And I was like, yes, I'd love to be in a short film. So I went along to my first student film that I was involved in. And Gavin was the writer-director of that as well as this. And basically he pushed me off a bridge. He made a life-size dummy made of me with my hair colour at the time, which was kind of dyed red, like clothes that I was wearing, like an exact replica. He opened the boot of the car and showed me this dummy of myself. And I was like, okay, yeah, cool, this is fine. I'm a street performer. I do theatre, I do film. I just love any kind of acting, really. We had a bit of conversation about lives, and I think I told him a bit of what I was going through. I was a bit depressed at the time. And Gavin talked to me about this project they had an idea for and that he thought I would be good in the role, and it sounded amazing. It sounded like something that I thought needed to be out there. Then he sent over the script and I read it and I thought, this is such a perfect representation of mental health. There is no place in it where it's like magically fixed and everything's fine. It's really real, it's really raw, and I would totally love to do it. So I'm really glad that Gavin talked to me about it and I was involved.
The question, did I want involved with it, was moot. Yes, absolutely. I was in a particularly dark place and I recognised a lot of what I was going through in the main character, Niamh. The people I knew I'd be working with were people that I genuinely liked. That it felt very much like a little rep company, but for film. We were friends first and filmmaker second, but when we were filming, the filmmaker side came first. And we mixed really well on screen, off screen. It was just a fantastic experience and it was very cathartic for me. It did a lot of healing that people I don't think, realised.
All of the parts were written for the people that were playing them. I knew Rowan was going to be the lead. And so that was it. You know, the character was written with her in mind. I knew Craig was going to be the dad. That was it. You know, the character was written for him. I put together a team of people that I liked, people that, you know, I found good friends with, or people that I respect and, you know, like their work, as well as some people who I hadn't worked with before, but who had a good feeling about.
Me and Gavin are friends and we met for a drink and he just started telling me about his upcoming projects. And he's like, oh, you're a composer, do you want to help? And I was like, yes, I do.
So I was working on another film and Gavin and Craig, who plays the dad, were talking about, oh, we need to find a guy roughly this age, you know, roughly looking like that. And I was like covered in like blood and shit and for this other film. And Craig just points over and like, what about him? And they asked me, I'm like, yeah, are you free to, would you like to do that? Are you free? I'm like, yeah, let me just check my calendar for November. Yep, that's me. I'm fine. Let's do it.
We met while working on another film and got telling me about this idea that you had for a short film. I liked the concept and thought it was actually a really important one to tell. It was a good team to work with because it felt like a real collaboration. After the first couple of days, it didn't feel like you were working with a group of people that you've just met. Like, you felt like I'd known these people for a long time.
So because it was to do with mental health and stuff, it kind of really spoke to me as well because I suffer a little bit sometimes with that. And I think I'd gone through quite a difficult time before we met up. It was good timing, I think, because I needed something to kind of throw myself at.
You can sit and watch a short film like this, which is maybe 10, 15 minutes long, but you don't really realise until you've done it the hours that go into just getting those 15 minutes, getting everybody organised, getting the sets right, locations. So much goes into it that as a viewer, you don't realise. and it's just a great experience. And even looking back at what me and Gavin done in the past in terms of the quality of the production, it's just night and day. But then again, I dare say in 10 years' time, if Gavin asks me to help on something again, you know, we'll look back at Cold and maybe think the same thing. It's just, it's ever, forever evolving, forever changing. And that's what I like about it. Personally, I've had to deal with health conditions and that, and I wasn't able to help out earlier on. It didn't feel like a daunting task coming in. It's almost at the midway point because, it, you know, everybody was very welcoming. They knew me. In a way, it didn't feel like I was ever not there. It was a very comfortable environment to work in.
We had such a great team, great dynamic on the set. You know, I've got really fond memories of, you know, us having a laugh or a scene going really well, being moved and emotional. For me, the social aspect is probably one of the most important aspects of filmmaking. This, you know, spending time with people who admire the work and admire what they're bringing to it, bringing things that I couldn't think of, but they themselves have contributed and conceived, and just, you know, it's phenomenal.
Most of the people involved in the film live in Scotland and work in Scotland, and I live in the Lake District, but it was actually no trouble at all doing all the travelling. I don't really mind travelling for one thing, and coming back to Scotland where I went to university was always such a good feeling. It feels like home as much as the lakes does.
Those sort of early couple of days that we spent in November 2018, very rushed process. We didn't have proper storyboards. We didn't have, you know, locations that I think were exactly what I hoped they would be. It felt like winging it. And that's why after those couple of days, I went, do you know what, this project matters to me. I want to make this work, I want to make it good. And so I kind of slowed down a little bit and thought, let's not rush this. Let's take some time. Let's make it the film that it should be. Started doing a lot more storyboards, had shot lists, you know, made sure the locations were what they needed to be. We reshot a few scenes that we'd previously shot as well, trying to make them sure they would be the best versions of them that we could be. And I think we really benefited from that, and I've learned from that as well.
The most satisfying thing of the whole filming experience was Gavin had come around to the house and said, oh, we need to get a place up where there's going to be snow, etc. But the cost, etc. And I was absolutely delighted to be able to just pull one up and go, right, okay, that's it, booked. And we went up and we couldn't have got a better place.
I mean, I've had issues with depression, anxiety in my own life. It's come and gone over the years. It's been quite difficult at times. What I've thought about a lot is there's a lot of people in my life that I care deeply about, and they've experienced depression, and you've been looking at it from the outside in. So I'm kind of coming at it from two perspectives. One is someone who's experienced these things, and one who's seen it in other people. And you know, when I was a child, Christmas was just the most wonderful, fantastic time. But then you become increasingly aware of the issues that are around Christmas, you know, and we don't find out what is driving Rowan's character's mental health issues in the film. We don't discover that, but I didn't want that to be the case because I wanted it to be universal. This is depression itself. We don't need to know the cause. And here's trying to be as honest as possible, an exploration of that.
I thought Neve as a character was very interesting, and I really liked that there wasn't any like linchpin for her depression. There was a lot of things going on with her. She was very nuanced. She didn't just cry all the time, only stare into space. She had a whole range of things. She went to Christmas with her family. She had times where she was receiving and getting gifts and smiling and feeling happy. She went up to see her dad, and I feel like she was so excited when she saw him. But then it always kind of goes down to a settle point, and the settle point is so much lower than really than anyone should be. And I feel like that's mental health like that, really. I have quite a lot of personal experience of depression that I was able to draw from, and it felt like it could rise to the surface quite easily. The struggle I had with portraying Neve was not seeming like I was happy, because I was so happy to be filming Neve, to be working with these wonderful people and to be involved in the film. So ironically, there were the happiest moments, those times we were filming.
Angus is a troubled person. He is still suffering from, I assume, a recent loss of his wife. And he has this daughter. I don't think he's ever really been 100% comfortable with dealing with women. He's very much, in the old sense, a man's man. There's emotional stuff that leave that to the women. And he is actually quite struggling with Neve, his daughter. It's not until the big scene between Neve and Angus that he suddenly realises what an emotional person he is. All the love that he'd held back because of the loss of his wife also immediately comes flooding out. And I approached it that way. I knew that Rowan and I worked well together. I had gone down to Ambleside to run lines with Rowan because it was such an important scene. Basically, we went to the pub and never ran the scene. So the first time we ever ran the scene together was on the day. But I had the confidence in working opposite Rowan that it was going to work, and it did. I am just so glad I didn't see what she was doing when I was delivering some of the lines. Otherwise, I don't think emotionally I would have been too stable.
The great thing about his dad in the film is that he reaches out to her and he lets her know that he's there for her. No matter what she's been like, she doesn't have to be bubbly and happy. She doesn't have to be something that she's not feeling. He loves her and he's there for her. And it was just so great working with Craig, portraying that, because we just had all that kind of affection between us already, because Craig's a great person, he's a great actor, and we just really worked well together.
We were filming that night up in Aviemore. One of the best nights of filmmaking I've ever had. I mean, I was moved to tears, and there was a point when they did a take, and then they turned to me and they were like, is that okay? And I was like, could you do it again, but a bit less emotional, because I was so moved. And, you know, I was tearing up, and, you know, that's when you know it's working, you know, and just, you know, that kind of raw emotion and that sense of, you know, I can't believe these guys are bringing this to it.
Because the two of them did really well. And the fact that I was standing in the background making jokes and making people laugh, like, they did well managing to keep the emotions in that scene going.
I've been in films where you got shouted at if you said the instead of and in the script, but Gavin, he really allowed us to get our own focus on the parts, and I honestly don't think I could have done any differently for the big emotional scenes.
Because if you've seen my CV and the amount of fake moustaches and like hysterical costumes that have been involved, I actually don't think I've had the chance to wear my own clothes and be the person that I am, but this face, that hair, and have a genuine scene basically in a place like a coffee shop. So that was, after all this time, possibly the most refreshing thing to do for my career. You need to show a kind of character like this in a piece where they don't get it. They want desperately to connect with this other person and utterly failing to see why that the way that you're going about it won't work. In the two-way conversation about mental health, of what people are actually suffering and what people around them suffer as well, it's just a tiny wee glimpse into somebody who is trying to get into that. But for reasons that are kind of obvious, it just can't work. There's a big selfishness to that character of turning something that shouldn't be about him into something that's about him. Asking why you're not connecting with me better. Yeah, it's not a really comfy place to know that you feel like that as well, that you've been in a position like that, because it's quite a kind of hard scene to navigate through. But there's a big selfishness there as well that's not obvious, because he seems like quite a nice person, but there is a lot of selfishness with that as well. First time I met Rowan, and anybody who meets Rowan for the first time, it's such a lovely experience that you don't want to be suddenly dropped into a scene where you're doing this horrendous kind of like heartbreak and disconnection. We didn't have a tremendous amount of time to do it. There were some nice kind of odd discoveries in that. We also did that scene twice, and it was interesting to go through and see what happened in both versions.
Initially, I was actually brought on as, I guess, an on-set photographer with this part to come on, but then I kind of picked up other stuff. It kind of goes part and parcel with my personal view of this industry. Is I just kind of adapt to what's thrown at me. I like to experience different areas as well. I just throw myself at it. And I always describe myself as an actor, but I'm also a photographer as well. I've recently gone into partnership with another photographer in Dundee, and I've got access to this whole new studio. Do a wide variety of things. I was in a feature film called Schemers, and hopefully I might be able to get some more work out of that and maybe eat. That'd be nice. But I've always said that if I could get acting to be the job that pays me decently on a regular basis, then I'd probably do photography for free because I love it so much. For me personally, like, just trying to find a way of delivering High Neve in a different way was just, like, without sounding like too much of a dick. It was a bit of a challenge, but I did it, I think, I hope.
You know, it's just those little things that you remember, and, you know, it brings a smile to your face when you think back on it. I wouldn't say highlight, more like low light. Probably holding the lilo bed over my own house window so we could film a nighttime scene through the day. It was kind of a weird moment, that, because it's like, well, this is my house. I'm having to stand outside while everything's going on. But at the same time, you know, you find joy in every aspect of it. I know it sounds really silly standing with a lilo bed holding up, but we actually had a really good laugh just being outside, telling my neighbours that everything's okay. We're just busy doing something.
I think it was just fun to hang out with everybody, to be honest. The composition process was based on a brief that Gavin wrote for me, so it was kind of like a few screenshots. I didn't actually have the live footage to work with. Kind of taking on everything that I'd kind of taken on from the actual being on set. I do a lot of ambient music, so it's quite kind of on par with everything else that I did. I think just the whole soundscape, ambient stuff's kind of my jam, really. So with depression, I think for me personally, it was almost like being like about 8 layers deep in your brain, when you just feel like you're just that far in that you can't really get out again. So it's kind of like creating like just a big, thick, kind of like layered sound that you kind of get lost in while you're watching it. It would have been really helpful to have the footage to kind of like play along with, but to be honest, I think it was kind of more fun because I think I had more freedom. I think if I have too much to kind of work with, it kind of puts me off. So I think sometimes just sitting down and going, I need to make 2 minutes of music, let's see what happens. Gavin seemed to like the music, almost spot on most times. I was like, oh cool, awesome.
The first draft, I can remember watching it, and once we watched it in its entirety, Gavin did ask me, what are your thoughts? And I felt at the time that it just didn't seem to flow. We're here, now we're there. And you know, we collaborated on that and we worked on it. We looked at what might work. We were able to take things that maybe weren't supposed to be where they ended up being, but it worked so much better for doing that. And it really helped establish the tone of the movie. You know, sort of the first couple of minutes, you get an idea of what's going on, even though there's no dialogue. And I think that really helped in the final draft, and it really got the message across.
So when we actually did the screening, and you kind of have this nervousness about it because you've had this kind of whole journey of putting it together, and you hope it's going to pan out, and you're obviously you're bringing all these people into a room to watch it, and then you say to yourself, okay, let's hope this works now.
So I was just like, just going to roll with it, see what happens. It was great to finally see the film, because obviously we've been working on it for so long and we're all so proud of it. It was great, and it was so amazing seeing all these moments together that had meant so much to me.
I remember speaking to Rowan's mum afterwards. I said, I'm so sorry for what I've done to your daughter. I feel terrible for putting her through that.
I was proud. I thought it did what it was meant to do. I thought that everybody had really brought their A-game to it.
I was like, oh, it's amazing. This is working. I think the bit that got me, I don't know what it was, because there was so much more emotive scenes, but the bit like with the snowflake bit, like that was, I don't know why that got me a little bit, but it did.
It was brilliant. It all fit together. It was like putting pieces to a jigsaw together, and to see the finished product was fantastic. I don't think we could have done a better job.
Gavin was very lucky to have got such an amazing group of people on one project, and getting that together and seeing it complete, and that we've all went through something together. We all had like different parts to play in it. You're just like, well, maybe that's why I'm an actor. Maybe it's just wanting to be a part of something. There's something bigger happening, and I got to be part of it.
We've all come together, we've all made this thing. I actually feel really proud of it now I've seen it. And it was so good working with everyone. Yeah.
For me personally, it just feels very reassuring, because it is just this reminder of you're not alone. And even though when things can feel really horribly bad, there's someone that you could talk to no matter who. Like, it is reassuring.
The most fulfilling and rewarding experience I think I've had in any kind of filmmaking experience, and incredibly motivating for the future, because I just want to go now and make more. I just want to, you know, create stuff to the best of my ability, and I just want to continue working with these phenomenal, brilliant people, and just let's do it. Let's just make some really kick-ass art, you know. Let's do it, you know. It's incredibly moving that people gave that much of their own time, their own effort, their own energy, brought so much of themselves to it, and I'm just immensely proud and immensely grateful, and I can't wait to see what's next.